Yo, what's up? Quiet, do you hear it? Do you hear the buzz from the new Power BI Modeling MCP server? I certainly do, so in this video, that's what we're gonna check out. I'm gonna show you how you can do bulk updates, use the MCP server to optimize your semantic model, and how to use it for your visuals. So you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking, let's head over to my laptop. So what I've already done previously is that I have installed the Power BI Modeling MCP server on my Visual Studio Code, and I'm ready to use it here in my Copilot GitHub chat. And if I click on the configure tools here, you see the Power BI Modeling MCP as a tool has been selected. So the chat is going to use that when I start asking the agent questions. Now, you could also do this with Claude. I know some of you use that. Here you have to do the installation a bit differently. I'm going to show you how to install the MCP server for both Visual Studio Code and Claude step by step in a separate video. So if you want to check that out, hit subscribe on GynaCube. Now back to my desktop. I think I want to use Claude for this demo today. So I'm going to ask it some question. Could you please connect to my Power BI report? Let's see what it does. I haven't even specified that I wanted to connect to this report that I have open here. My compare videos MCP demo report. Okay, that was not that impressive. Fine. Okay, let's be more specific. Can you connect to my compare videos MCP demo report? What's very interesting about the MCP servers is that it's not gonna do the same thing every time. So now I had to specify. Last time I didn't have to. So what it's doing now is that yes, let me connect to that, and it's asking me, let me first check what local instances are available of the Power BI MCP server, because it's trying to connect to that one. So I'm going to allow that once. Ah, amazing, it found it and it wants to connect, and I'm also going to allow that. Now it even gives me some options on what I should do. Let's just ask it to, can you help with suggestions on how to optimize the report? And I don't even have to use correct English, I think, for it to understand what I want to do. Yes, it will be happy to optimize my report. It's asking me also to dive into the measures to understand the complexity. Cool, it's quite thorough, I would say. Okay, so let's see what it says. It says that we can do some relationship optimization. We can also do some measure improvements. It's talking about data model structure, that I can hide some columns. I can do some date table optimization. And it's even telling me that I did well on the measure table setup because I have a measure collection here. Thank you. Potential aggregation opportunities. Okay. But oh, okay. Also some quick wins. Add description to all measures for documentation. All right. Let's see if we can just do that. I want to add descriptions for my measures. Now, before I hit enter here, I want to just, in the modeling view here, I want to open up the measures. Let's look at total views. You see here that we don't have a description for this one yet. And let's ask it to create some descriptions and hit enter. Okay, cool. So it asked me to retrieve each measure to first understand what they do and then add appropriate descriptions. Now it's going to do a batch update. And I can even go through the code here to see what it does and see if I like this. But let's just hit allow once and pay attention to this view here. Let's see if it actually updates. We see, oh, Power BI is working on it, and boom, we have a description. It returns the maximum view count from the video stats table for the current filter context. That is correct. Maybe that was an easy measure. What about my video star? Yeah, this is pretty nice. So this is generating an SVG image of 5 circles where full dots represent the video rating. So that's correct too. Okay, it did a pretty good job. But what if we then ask it to create some SVGs for us? Because in my report here, I do already have some SVG visuals, these dots showing the score of the different videos. So let's ask it, could you give me some suggestions on SVGs that I could implement with DAX code? Give me 3 examples. Let's hit enter and see what it comes up with. Okay, so we got one progress bar with gradient fill, and it got a code here. It got some sparkline chart. Okay, cool. And also a speedometer. Huh, interesting. Okay, so let's ask it to please create the number 1 with the progress bar with gradient fill. Let's see if it can do that for us. Now, I didn't specify anything on where to put this measure, so let's see what it does. And wow, now we see progress bar SVG It's a measure. Oh, how it put in a lot of DEX code for us. Now, what I think is interesting here is that if I open up here, I can see what it did. And apparently it tried to do it, but it got an error. It didn't work and it got an error message. And then in the next step, it's actually trying to fix the error. It tries again and then it did not get an error. And according to Claude, it actually did work. So now we do have a progress bar here. So let me just duplicate this page. And let's see what happens if I change this to the progress bar. We got something, but we can't see anything. I mean, apparently there's numbers below. So it's telling me that this one had 25,000 out of 10,000 views. All right, but it doesn't look like it's performing correctly. So what happens if I just tell it that the whole thing is black? Can you fix that? Well, no, it's still not working. Are you sure the progress bar gets the correct colors? Okay, so that apparently fixed it. But I had to be really, really specific and telling it with capital letters. Make sure. No, I'm just kidding. This only proves that you cannot always trust AI to fix stuff for you. But here it actually, I think it did a pretty good job. Now let's ask it to only keep the percentage, make the percentage black and have it on the right side. It did definitely create some SVGs for me. I didn't have to do anything in DAX. Obviously, if you are good at with SVGs, you could just figure out what it did wrong yourself. But let's also ask it to do some more complicated DAX for me. Now, if you're like me and you checked out Patrick's previous videos, you have already learned all the things about DAX user-defined functions. Now, I am no DAX expert whatsoever, so I want to check out if the MCP server can help me do what Patrick did. Okay, so it says, yes, DAX user-defined functions, as a powerful feature. You're currently not using any, I know. So here are the recommendations. So the SVG generation, that's a good use case because I do have a bunch of SVG measures here. And let's see, I do have some color logic pattern that it can implement. And I also have three guiding cube specific calculations that it could fix. So you know what, let's just create UDFs for all your suggestions, please. Oh no. Okay, so it tells me that the report itself is not compatible. So apparently my file is too old. So let's see if it can fix that for us. Okay, so now it has created the user-defined functions, but apparently it got some issues with the progress bar that it just created. So let's see if it's able to fix it for us. Okay, so it did really, really, really do some debugging here because it apparently couldn't make it work. Now it tells me that, okay, so it says the Pi by desktop is limited and experimental. I'm not sure if I'm buying that, but okay. Alternative solutions. Let's revert the progress bar to the working version. Okay, so it's telling us that it did create the 9 UDFs. I mean, they're in the report. So let's see where we can find them. If I go into the model view and open up data model here, you see that we have 9 functions, but I see that all of them got an error. Wait, stop. Okay, for some reason, it doesn't work. Yesterday, when I tried this, because I did actually test this before I decided to record, it worked. So let me just show you what that looked like. Here in a separate report, this is a different one. You do see here that I also created some different SVGs. And if we now go in here, check out the model view, we also see that I do have 2 functions, format SVG number and get performance color. And if we do take a look at the measures, like this one, for instance, for the performance bar, you see I've created a bunch of different SVGs here. You do see that did actually work. It did use the get performance color and format SVG number, and it did save me a lot of code lines in my DAX measures. So wait, what happened here? Well, sometimes AI lies to us, or I mean, it doesn't mean to lie. It just really, really want to tell me something that I want to hear, but we also looked at all the awesome things that you could do with the MCP server. We did bulk updates, we optimized the semantic model, we created SVGs, we also showed how it didn't work. Now in the next video, I am gonna show you how to install it, both for Visual Studio Code and Claude. So hit subscribe if you want to check that out, or if it's already out, it might be hovering above my head. As always, thank you for watching and we will see you guys in the next video. Bye!